found the body?
No, that was Clarity. She's still too shaken up to be interviewed, so I offered to go first.
We've had a word from the hospital. Abby is still alive, but she's in a coma.
Oh, thank God she isn't dead.
All right, Sophia, tell us, when did you see Abby today?
Well, I first saw her this morning when she came to school.
What's that like, party 7-8? That's way cool. I mean, seriously, I haven't been to a party that often for like a whole month.
Yeah, it was totally fun. Especially the part when Jessica fell in the
pool. Hey guys, what you talking about?
Nothing important, just this party last Saturday night.
The party?
Without me?
I gave you the invitation, didn't I?
No.
Oh, sorry. My mistake.
Yeah. Sorry you couldn't be there.
Oh, are those our lattes?
It's good.
Yeah.
Great, thanks. This is like.
Macaroni.
Great. See you later.
Yeah.
See ya.
I got it! I got you, Captain! Yes! 30 in a row!
Yay! Good for you! I got it.
Okay.
You stole my brother's scholarship spot. How dare you?
Yeah.
Well, it's not my fault my dad is from the States and that I'm filthy rich.
Of course I was angry. She thinks she can steal my brother's scholarship spot just because her dad went to a high school with the dean.
And so naturally, you tried to kill her?
What? Aww.
And where will everything wanted to spend this afternoon?
Math class, just asking Miss Brown. I never leave class.
Oh, we will. But it would be in your best interest to tell us everything that happened after you confronted Abby.
Oh, well, that's jumping, come on.
Back off, man.
We're not doing this.
Aw, thank you, Sean. You're my hero.
Anything for you.
Aw, you're so sweet.
Yes, Joseph is telling the truth. He and Sam walked away, and then Abby gave Sean a huge hug. I saw the whole thing, and everyone knows that Sean has the biggest crush on Abby. So naturally, I want to tell Abby's boyfriend, Matt.
Oh my gosh, I just saw your girlfriend hugging Sean. She doesn't like you anymore. So since she doesn't like you, how about me and you go out? Doesn't that sound great?
What? I won't believe it until I see it. Oh, by the way, it's probably not gonna happen.
Yeah, man, I saw her too. She's dumb.
What? This is nonsense.
So, can we go out now?
No.
Are you sure?
No.
So you're not sure?
Yes. Get away from me.
Just think about it.
You were so upset that Matt rejected you that you tried to kill his girlfriend.
What? No way. Matt didn't reject me. He'll come around. You'll see. And why would I kill someone? Gross.
And then we have PT1 to finish
this TJ and I were studying for the upcoming mathlete competition.
Yeah, we were studying.
So when was the last time you saw Abby today?
Around lunchtime, I think. She had a huge fight with her boyfriend.
So I heard you were cheating on me.
What? No, I have no idea what you're talking about.
I'm pretty sure you know exactly what I'm talking about.
No, really, I don't.
Well, Caleb told me that Sean asked you out and you said yes and you guys started hugging really tightly.
What? That's not true. Do you really think I would do that?
Well, yes, you never really were dedicated to relationships.
But not this time, I promise.
You know what? I'm done. Of course I was furious. I just found out she was cheating on me. So I broke up with her immediately.
But that just wasn't enough. So then you tried to kill her.
No way I didn't do it. I was just killed the rest of the day. Ask him.
Yeah, Matt broke up with Abby and then hung out with me the rest of the day. It's all true.
Are you sure? Because if you're leaving anything out, you can end up looking pretty guilty.
But it's all true except for the part where I lied about what I saw.
What do you mean?
I told Matt that Abby said yes to Sean because I wanted him to break up with her so we can have so we can hang out. We used to be best friends till she stole him from me.
Is that why you tried to kill Abby?
No way. If anyone wanted to kill her, it was Sean.
So I was wondering. Things are so sweet. Do you want to go out with me?
You're funny. Stop. Wait, you're not kidding. Go out with you? No. I'm already going out with someone who's so much better. See ya.
Good judgment, crazy.
did try to kill her.
And where do you have to take one to get to it?
I was in history class. You can ask Mr. Brown. If anybody were to kill Abby, it would be Claire.
Are you crazy?
It's Matthew.
Oh, like whatever. You always get everything you want. Like, I should be chief captain because I'm like way prettier. Shut up! You know me when I'm nervous! Just stupid to be cheer captain anyway. Can't imagine we, like, got them to choose you.
I had to steal from you for the last time. And, like, you don't even understand. You didn't even let me finish.
Please, like, I need to. Everything's always about you. I mean, you're, like, the worst best friend ever!
Yeah!
I hate you! Then I guess we're through.
It's true, we got into a huge fight.
And that's when you tried to kill her.
No, I left.
But you were the one who found Abby's body.
Yeah, well, later. When I heard about the breakup, I went to go find Abby and apologize. And that's when I found her, lying on the ground, unconscious. I know how this looks, but I swear, when I left her after our argument, she was conscious and alive. I didn't do it, really.
And what time did you leave Abby after the argument?
1 p.m. Ask Sophia and Matt. I walked right past them on the way back to
class. You two saw Claire in the hallway.
Mm-hmm.
She says you were talking when you saw her. Is that true?
Yeah.
And what was the conversation about?
Well, I saw Matthew and Abby break up, so I went to see if he was okay.
Hey, you okay?
I guess so. I just can't believe she did this.
I'm sorry.
I really thought she was the one.
Well, maybe it'll work out for the best. Maybe you'll find somebody way better who's actually nice to other people and...
Hey, just because we broke up doesn't mean you need to be mean to her like that. She is a nice person.
She is not a nice person. Maybe to you, in a sick, twisted, manipulative way, she's a jerk and she was only using you. Are you so blind you can't see that? I know you weren't happy with her.
I don't really need this right now.
Matthew.
I gotta go.
And then he left.
What time was that?
Around 1:15.
That's interesting. Clarity told us it was 1 p.m. sharp.
Well, she's obviously lying. It was definitely 1:15.
The thing is, Matthew confirmed Clarity's story. He says that it was 1 p.m. And his teacher confirms that he was back at class at 1:05. We know you're lying, Sophia, so just tell us why.
Well, I mean, it could have been 1 o'clock. It's not like I was having a staring contest with the clock or something.
Your teacher confirms that you didn't get back to class until 1:20. So what were you doing for 20 minutes?
Getting my books.
It took you 20 minutes to get your books and walk to a class less than 30 feet from where you were with Matthew.
Yeah, I was tired.
I've been busy with you.
You know what I think? I think you finished talking with Matthew, went to the bathroom, saw Abby, the girl who caused your best friend since childhood a whole load of pain, and you snapped. You started hitting.
No.
But you hit one too many times, and suddenly she stopped struggling and stopped moving.
That's not what happened.
Then you tried to wake her up, but she wouldn't respond.
Stop.
So then what do? You simply wash your hands, pick up your books, and go to class. It's sick.
No.
Yes, you hit her again and again and again, and now she's in a hospital bed, dying.
You don't understand. That's not what happened. I had to do it. That little brat gets everything she wants, and she hates everybody, and Matthew likes her. That's what's sick. It was just me and him, and then that perky, empty-headed, manipulative little monster comes in and hypnotizes him, and he's love-struck. I tried to warn him, but he wouldn't listen to me. No. He walked straight into the witch's arm. Haunted him. He never stopped talking about her, and soon he was the only one that he would ever hang out with. And then she breaks his heart, and I go to comfort him despite all that he's done to me, and he pushes me away. She haunted him, and they weren't even together. Don't you see? Now he can be free. Now he can be with somebody who actually cares about him. Aren't you proud of me, Matthew? I saved you. I saved us. You could see that I'm the one who understands you. Been here all along, so why can't you see? You belong with me. You belong with me. Hey guys, moral of the story time.
There's quite a few.
Like, don't lie. That's just not good.
It's bad, guys. I mean, it's not cool.
It hurts people's
feelings. And don't be violent. Violence is not the answer.
Not good. If you're gonna kill someone, which is totally not good, but if you are,
Don't wear pretty clothes because they are going to look at me.
Yeah, that would not be good because, well, fashion is very important.
So that's basically the moral of the story.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, and don't eat potato chips all the time because that's really bad for you.
Yeah. High calories.
Never been till you put me down. Oh, I knew you were trouble when you walked in. So shame on me now. Blew me to places I've never been. Now I'm lying on the cold, hard ground. Oh, oh, trouble, trouble, trouble.
Guys?
Yeah.
Lights, camera. Okay, go again.
You were like, look at the ground. Or...
Look at me.
Okay, wait.
No. Sean, seriously? Stop it.
Sean, what the heck?
Back off, man. This is not the time.
We're not doing
this. Oh, thank you, Sean.
Of course I was furious. I just found out she broke up with me.
Action.
Now I can't miss somebody who actually loves him. Or what?
I don't know how this looks, but I swear, after I left her, after our argument, dang it.
Action.
Back off, man.
We're not doing this.
Don't look.
After I left her, after our argument, I went to.
Oh, like whatever.
Sorry.
Doesn't that sound great?
What? I can't believe this. I'm sorry. Wait. Sorry. Okay. Wait, what? Are you saying?
And
what?
Go.
I gave her everything. I just can't. I really. I never even looked like talking to her.
So I heard you were cheating on me.
No.
So I heard you were cheating on me.
Sorry.
So I heard you were cheating on me.
No, I don't know what you're
really tightly.
That's not true, I swear.
I'm pretty sure you know exactly what I'm talking about.
What?
Caleb told me that you guys were talking really tight and he asked you out and he said yes.
That is not true.
Wait, Sean asked you out. You're still my brother's scholarships.
Nope, you gotta be more angry.
Yeah,
walk up to her angry. And be like, you stole my brother's scholarship spot. Action.
Oh, thank you, Sean. You're my hero.
Anything for you,
Anna. Oh, you're so sweet.
Yeah, I was mad. The girl drives me crazy. And maybe I can.
What?
I was.
And maybe. Oh, wait. Oh.
Get
you.
Yeah, I was mad. The girl drives me crazy.
And maybe if you want.
Come on, Roger.
Come on, Roger.
He's my.
We're rolling.
Yeah. I was mad.
Now he can be with